Hey everybody, welcome to Jet City. Today we're going to talk about the books I recommend to learn about jet engine. There are four types of books you may be interested in, depending on the type of person you are. If you are a real techno geek or a technician, or you need to look at an actual engine you might own, you want what's known as an illustrated parts catalog, which I'll show you in a second. The illustrated parts catalog has all of the individual pieces right down to the last washer and bolt and nut and clamp, everything listed by part number and how many you need. And there's a pretty good diagram of where it goes. It shows an assembly as an exploded diagram with a number pointing to each piece, and it will list the part number and tell you what it is. You can't necessarily identify parts without part numbers on them by the IPC because the diagrams aren't that clear. Okay, that's the Illustrated Parts Catalog, also called the Illustrated Parts Book or IPB. IPC or IPB, either one. That's a little detailed for most people that are just interested in jet engines. Now, the second type of book that you can get has a lot of information, doesn't have the same information as the IPC. It is the overhaul manual for the engine. Now, if you're interested in a newer engine, it's going to be extremely expensive and very hard to get, probably not worth your time. But for example, here is the overhaul manual for the J47. We'll show you this in detail in a second. This was purchased from a place called eflightmanuals.com, and I will show you their address. It is the actual overhaul manual for the J47 engine. We'll look at a lot of these pages. But what it shows photographs, which are not in the IPC. The IPC is only exploded diagrams. It shows photographs of procedures. It spends a lot of time on inspection of parts and damage and repair limits and how to repair that, a lot of it. And then there are specific procedures, for example, if you wanted to remove the oil filter, or if you wanted to completely disassemble the engine, or if you wanted to box the engine up for shipping, or if you wanted to test the engine. The procedures are very detailed. It's not as exciting as you might think. That's quite a small manual because that's a very old, very simple engine. Modern engines, the overhaul manuals are about that thick. I think we covered in a recent video the overhaul manuals for the LM500, which is the CF and TF34, which is the engine in the A10, among other airplanes. That's a book like this. Okay? So the overhaul manual is also quite dry, except for, and we'll show you this, the introduction section. The introduction section of an overhaul manual is basically a description of engine and operation. So it's quite interesting. It tells you the basics of how the engine works. It's like an introductory paragraph. It's a section. It's a whole chapter. It's very interesting to guys like me, maybe guys like you. But the overhaul manual in general is a service and repair manual. Not terribly exciting. Okay, that's the IPC and the overhaul manual. Those two things are what you need to work on the engine. If you have a Renda Type 10, or a J47, or a J44, or a J57, or any of these actual jet engines from the good old days, if you want to work on it, your job will be made 100 times easier if you have the instructions and the pictures. Doesn't that make sense? So the IPC is a way to make sure that the part you're putting in is the right part and it's going in the right place. And the overhaul manual is the instructions of how to do it. And often there are secrets that you just can't get by hacking away at something. There's either special tooling or special procedures or things that you can't see. So those two are the professional books. Now, another two categories of books that I recommend. I'm going to show you the actual books that I recommend here. This is the textbook in the course I took a long time ago. I've shown you this picture many times. We're going to look at this close up in a second. This is Aircraft Gas Turbine Power Plants by Charles Otis. It's from Jeppesen Publishing. And it's basically, it takes somebody who's an interested reader, and let's just take a look at, chapter one is History of Turbine Development. Chapter two is Jet Propulsion Theory. A lot of questions about this on my videos. Chapter three is Turbine Engine Design and Construction. This is where we get into the actual modules, like the inlet, the compressor, the bearings, the diffuser, the combustor, the turbine, the afterburner, and the exhaust nozzle. Those things are spoken of and discussed and illustrated in great detail. Then there's engine familiarization with specific engines in here. The JT8D, the most produced large turbine engine ever. The Allison 250, which is the engine in the Bell Jet Ranger. There's lots of those out there. The PT6, which is a turboprop that is very common in light aviation and small passenger aircraft. The CM56, which is what's in the modern 737s, among many other aircraft. It's a very good engine. Then there's other chapters on inspection and maintenance, lubrication system, fuel system, compressor anti-stall system. Ooh, anti-stall. This talks all about compressor stall and how to avoid it, which is the subject of an upcoming video. The reason it's taking so long is I'm not going to use any equations and any geometric diagrams. We're going to talk about it, and you're going to understand it. It's going to make sense to you without needing to do math and geometry. So it's kind of hard for me to get that down. Just have patience. But it's all in this book. Starter systems, ignition systems, engine instrument systems, fire detection, and engine operation. So you see, it's got it all. A lot of the times, almost, I would say at least 50% and almost 90% of each video, when there's questions asked about technical details of the engine, I will want to pipe up, but I'll first hold my tongue and I will check just to make sure in this book. Now, there are other books. Another excellent one is the A&P Technician book, handbook, textbook. There's a workbook and a textbook. The A&P Technician textbook is also put out by Jeppesen. Looks a lot like this. And an A&P is an American engine, and it's airframe and power plant, aircraft and power plant. They specialize in different areas, but if you're an engine person in the States, you probably have a copy of the A&P textbook in your bookcase somewhere. And so these books are 50, 60 bucks, whatever. They're also in your library. Remember those things where they have books on shelves? You can sign them out and read them. They're in your library. Okay, so that's the third type of book, which is an introductory textbook. Very interesting, probably the most useful to anybody that is watching this video that wants to learn about jet engines, how they work. And it's the book that will allow you to decide whether or not you want to continue on and become a professional in this industry. Hopefully. Okay, that's three types. Oh, and before we move on to the fourth type, this is the book that started it all for me. I thought it was much older. We'll show this in close up as well. I've written a little history in here. I'll read that in just a second. But it's from 1967, so it's not that old, because jet engines started to come into the mainstream in the 40s. So by 67, they were a definite big, big thing. So I was cleaning out a house I was moving out of in Nanaimo, and I saw this book in the corner. It said Jet Engine Fundamentals. So I read it, and it's very simple. And older books and older movies and older documentaries, as you know, they have more information than the new ones do. So this is what got me hooked. This book is partially to blame for the reason I'm right here, right now. Okay, so let me read what I've written here. Summer 1998, found this book in the basement of a rented house. I'm keeping it. April 2002, enrolled in gas turbine technician program at BCIT. Previously, British Columbia Vocational School. That's important. Hang on. February 2003. Completed program, 92% average, best all-around student, class GT19. Yay! July 2003. started working at TransCanada Turbines in Calgary. Yeehaw. So that's my little history here. Now, I'm going to get in trouble for this. I'm going to get in trouble. The book is stamped. Now, I was in Nanaimo, BC, on the island, on Vancouver Island, when I found this book. And it looked, I thought it was from the 50s, so I thought, who cares, right? But it is stamped with a faded stamp. This book is property of BC Vocational School, Burnaby, BC. Burnaby, BC is across the water on the mainland. And I assumed that it was older than it was, and maybe I should mail it back. Anyway, it's 2017 right now. And so that's, the book is 40 years old? 50 years old. 50 years old. Yeah, so like I said, formerly BCVS, BC Vocational School. That's, I went to the school that this book was, well, it was either stolen or forgotten to be returned to. So maybe I'll mail it back. Anyway, this is an introductory textbook. This one's even more of a interest book. It's for an interested reader, not a technical reader, but these are the best kind, the very best kind of book. So I recommend these kinds of books. They're in your library, and you don't need a specific title, although I've given you a couple. Just start looking. If you develop the technique of looking and finding, you'll get better and better at it. There is no magic pill, and I cannot spoon feed you. Okay. Fourth type of book, also very interesting in a different way. This is called, and we'll show these all in close-up, The History of North American Small Gas Turbine Aircraft Engines. Long title. The reason I bought this book, this was kind of expensive, it was $85. It talks about specifically the engine in the start cart. It talks about specifically that engine, the T-58. It talks about specifically the Allison 250, the Bell Jet Ranger engine. It's all about how the engine, who thought it up, how it came to be required, how it came to be decided on how to make it that way, and the people involved in the development of the business throughout the history of how the engine came to be, which is different from discussing the technical aspects of the engine. So it's like, well, why did they do that? Why did they make the Allison 250 inside out, so to speak? It's got an inlet, a compressor. The compressor sends the air to the back, and then the combusted air goes towards the forward. It comes out the power turbine and out the middle. Why does it do that? Why doesn't it just go straight through like a T-58? Engine comes in one end, goes out the back end, spins the turbine and compressor, and away you go. And then the exhaust gases turn a power turbine behind it. So the inlet and the output is here. Why isn't the 250 like that? The 250's got the inlet, and the output's in the middle of the engine, the mechanical output and the exhaust output. Why'd they do that? Why'd they fold the engine in half? There's a good reason. They talk about that. And then there's the bigger brother to that engine, and then there's the PT6 and the PT7, which became the PW series. All kinds of fantastic stuff that you don't have to know to work on the engines, but I think is great. Okay. So these are the books that they're my favorite. I recommend them. I have no association with any of the publishers of these books. I don't get a penny either way. I hope they don't sue me for copyright for showing images of their books, but hey, if one of you people out there buy these books, it's only helping them, right? So why would they complain? I don't know. Anyway, let's take a look at these books in close up right now. Okay, this is my favorite book. I guess one of my favorite books. Aircraft Gas Turbine Power Plants. You should be able to get the information off of here. I actually gave the ISBN number on a recent video and it was incorrect. No big deal. You should be able to recognize this book. And if you can't from this, then I really don't know what to do. You should have already found this book on your own. If you're asking me about books for jet engines, it's got everything. Everything. Let's see. Oh, wait a second. Oh, speed of sound. We need to find out, where's that chapter? See, I'll show you what I'm trying to, so page 8-1. I'm trying to simplify to make it more fun. Oh, I've even got a divider there, look at that. What is that, a business card? Yeah, that is a P-40 Warhawk, Legendary Aviation. Okay. Compressor anti-stall. These are the diagrams I don't want to have to reproduce because they have to be extremely accurate. they talk about how to prevent a compressor from stalling. These diagrams are very important. I'm going to use no equations, just words, and maybe a few simple diagrams, but hopefully none. It will explain why anti-stall is needed, what stall is, and it'll all make sense because the variable stators and the bleed valves are totally different things, which we've talked about before in a previous video, but they have the exact same effect through a different mechanism. Okay, so anyway, this book is great. That one, this one, I recommend this book. Cannot say that enough. Okay, was that the third kind of book? I should go in order, sorry about that. We have the overhaul manual for the J47. Oh, I forgot about this guy. We'll show that in a minute. J47, this is from a place called, should freeze frame on these guys. There we go. eFlightManuals.com. You got that? eFlightManuals.com. They have a website. They have zillions of manuals. I actually bought another manual for them on how to put together a YB49 flying wing. Believe it or not, they have those manuals. And so there, that's the first type I mentioned, I believe, if my memory serves me correctly, which it probably doesn't. Placeholder, solid titanium alloy. Okay, now this is a blank cover, but we've got this set up as a, where's that piece of steel I had in there? Oh, there we go. Okay, so this is an example of an IPC. Most of my IPCs are on PDF right now, so this is of a variable displacement axial piston fuel pump for a very old jet engine. This is figure 6.4, diagram for table of limits. Okay, all these pieces. And then you'll be accompanied by figure 6.44. That's in the frame. Figure 6.44, figure number on figure 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this is an IPC for clearances, which is also interesting. Let's pick number 9. That's a brass rotor or a steel rotor in a carbon bearing. Right there, number 9 goes to right there. So, number 9 says bearing bore. It can be 2.445 to 2.446 inches. So it's got a 1/1000th of an inch range. Diameter of sleeve and carbon bearing effectively or selectively assembled to give the clearances as quoted. So your sleeve is going to have, sleeve is 8, 438 to 439. So it's got a 1 thou tolerance in its manufacture and a 1 thou tolerance in manufacture of the bearing bore. So you want to have a total tolerance. Okay, so the fit is to be 007 to 0.0, so 7 to 8 thousandths. Yeah, that's what it is. So permissible worn 9 thousandths. So it's going to be, you want to make it have a clearance of 7 to 8 thousandths of an inch for proper functioning, and it's going to be 9 thousandths of an inch maximum. That's the kind of information you need to build one of these things from all the pieces. So that's like an IPC. This is more of an IPC. Figure 9.5, overspeed diaphragm assembly. And figure 9.5. It's got all the pieces, and it says how many are needed. And this usage code usually means which version of which pump it's used on. So very detailed information. And this is the actual part number. And you can see there's a washer, AN123965 for a washer. So you want to use that actual washer, and if you don't have one, you can't just make it up. That's an IPC. That's the second type. So yeah, we just covered the third type, which is the these guys. And this again is this book, Specific Engines. This is a T56 with the funny looking gearbox out front where the prop goes. What's this? This is, oh, that's a kind of a rare engine. We've got Pratt & Whitney J57, Pratt & Whitney JT3C, which is a non-military J57. Have they got the J79 in here? They should. TF-33, that's That's similar to the engine in the B-52. JT8D is the old 737s, what people call the pipe engines. This is what was in the old 737-200 series. J-79 right there. Okay, so forward turbofan with mixed exhaust, non-mixed exhaust. It's all the basics, very interesting. Turbojets, turbofans, turboprops, old school centrifugal compressors, dual spool. Oh, the thrust equation, which we had a big thing about that back in that video called Jet Engine Thrust. Okay, so all about jets. This is a very good book. I don't know if you can find it. This guy, that's the title. Okay, highly recommended. And then, last but not least, we have this. It's got Forward by Hans von Ohain, who a lot of people believe is the inventor of the jet engine. I think it was him and Frank Whittle at the same time, basically. Please let's not debate it here in the comments. So, introduction, small gas turbine, genesis of the industry, Teledyne. These are the different manufacturers, Lycoming, GE, Williams, Pratt & Whitney, Allison, Garrett. Garrett makes more gas turbine engines than they do turbochargers, honestly, really, really, really. Miniature and model turbine engines, ooh-wee, that's what you want to see. Historical evolution of the industry. So, it's a lot to do with people and organizations and businesses, not a lot of diagrams, not a lot of pictures, but it does talk about how these things came to be. And it talks a lot about engines that never did become big, but they were the predecessors to what we now know as the devices we love. Teledyne Continental TP500. It didn't really take off like the PT6 did. But you can see there's not a lot of pictures. This is a very, very, very detailed book. And it's of interest to people of really doing investigative work. That's a PT6. It is. Recognized it. Bing bang. And it talks about, say, for example, selling the PT6. A lot of details, a lot of references. This is the kind of plane the PT6 is in, lots of them. Anyway, very good books. So, a history of the industry, a history of the development of the engine. We've got the, oh, and there's that other one. Another example of that same book, same type of book. This one was sent to me by our always orbiting gas turbine engineer, Graham J9101. That's not him there, but it could be. History of the Rolls-Royce Turbofan Engine by these guys. So there is one book we don't have a copy of here. It looks like this, but it's blue, and it's called The Jet Engine by Rolls-Royce. The Jet Engine by Rolls-Royce. So you can find that online. Somebody recently messaged me that they found a copy for, I think it was $50. These have got amazing diagrams in it. Well, this is the oil system. A lot of systems, actually. Passenger carrying stand, oh, the fuel system. Okay. Very complex diagrams. Anybody? Let's back away for a second and we will continue this. Anybody who messages me and says, I want your help designing a new jet engine, or I have a new great design for a jet engine, can you help me develop it? Or I've got a great new idea, can you help me get in touch with the right people? If you're one of those people, you should read, you should have already read this, should have, and you should read something like this, The History of the Development of Something, okay? The RB211, or any of the smaller engines, and you'll realize that what seems like a relatively simple thing is a gigantically, monstrously expensive and complex thing to do. And no, Rolls-Royce, GE, Garrett, they're not going to take your drawing on a piece of paper and run with it and make something great out of it, because they have hundreds and hundreds of professional engineers doing that already with supercomputers. So a orange crayon drawing on a napkin of some new thing, they're not going to run with it. So you have to you have to take it further than that. These are the stories of people who've done that, and it will impress upon you how much of an effort it is to design a gas turbine engine. It's probably, I'm going to say, more than 10 times the resources in computers and engineering and money, more than 10 times, possibly 1,000 times, it takes to develop a commercial airliner engine as opposed to a passenger vehicle engine, whether for a bus or a car, or a boat. These things are hideously complex and expensive to develop. Just ask Graham. Anyway, so these are the books I recommend. They're awesome. Don't forget about The Jet Engine by Rolls-Royce. You should be able to remember that title, The Jet Engine by Rolls-Royce. The Jet Engine by Rolls-Royce. Google that and you'll find it. It's a book that looks just like this. It's that thick, looks just like this. It's got fantastic color diagrams. It's my other favorite book. So that plus this, and if you read the same thing from two different sources, you get a better idea of what's really going on. I really recommend that. So if you spent $50 on this one and $50 on The Jet Engine, you're out $100 and you become an expert. If you learn everything in this book and everything in The Jet Engine by Rolls-Royce, you'll know more than me, honestly. Maybe that's not saying a whole lot, but they're also in your library, honestly. And I'm sure if you ask your librarian, remember, that's like the person. There's a human being in the building with the books that you can talk to. If they don't have that book, they can get it for you, and they probably will. So, or they'll tell you where it is. And then you get to take a book home and read it for free. You can read the book. You see, you take one of these things, a page, and you do that, and there's more stuff. You don't have to click on anything. You don't need power. It even works outside without electricity. Books are amazing. Anyway, these are the books I recommend. There are lots more, but I've been asked which ones I recommend. I haven't seen a whole lot of books on gas turbine engines that I don't like. These are the ones I do like. And check out E-Flight manuals from the shop in front of the race bike, which is not turbine powered, but we're working on it. Thanks for watching.